Hello, K-Love family. It's Riley Clemens coming to you live from the beautiful Nashville, Tennessee for a K-Love summer concert series. I'm so excited. We have music for you. We have encouragement for you. All the good stuff. We're going to chat, hang out, because that's what summer is all about, you guys. I'm so excited. I'm gonna wait, let some of you guys join the party before we kick it off with some music. But this is so fun. I have so enjoyed watching this concert series over the summer, and I know you guys have been tuning in and checking it out, but it's so special. If we can't be together in person, at least we can do a live stream and be connected that way. And the whole church said, amen. So, before we dive into this first song, I'm going to tell you a little bit of the heart behind it. So, I remember walking into the studio on the day that we wrote Fighting For Me, and I was overcome by this feeling of wanting to write something that was unifying among all people, you know, no matter who you are or where you come from or what your history is or where you are in the present moment. I think that all people have this desire to be fought for and loved in a way that shows up as unconditional love. And I was so inspired by how the love of God does that, how it finds you in any place that you are and loves you unconditionally. I think that's a really beautiful thing. God fights our battles for us in ways that go far beyond anything we could ever imagine. And for that, I am so grateful. I wrote this song as a reminder, not only to myself, but anybody listening, that God is fighting for you when you can't fight for yourself. He is on your side. He is close. And so we're going to play you a little tune that we call Fighting For Me.
Things right, okay.
band back here, you guys. We're having a good time. We're so happy to be hanging out with you guys. If you're just tuning in, welcome. We are in the K-Love Summer Concert Series, playing some music, hanging out, being together, all the good stuff. This is always such a special time to get to hang out with anybody, especially K-Love. I'm a K-Love baby. I grew up on K-Love. I was sitting in the back seat of my mom's car on the way to school listening to K-Love. So this is really just a really amazing God moment to just get to hang out with you guys and play you music. And I'm so grateful for K-Love and all of the amazing things that they're doing. I know you guys love K-Love. I know you're clapping behind your screens for K-Love, y'all. I know we're not there together, but I feel like we really are connecting on a very deep level. So that's amazing. Again, I'm Riley Clemens. I'm so excited to be here hanging out. I hope that song that we just played, Fighting For Me, encouraged you exactly where you are. Over the past year, 2020, I think it brought a lot of unexpected to everybody. I think you, whether you're sitting behind your computer or your phone, are nodding your head in agreement that, yes, last year brought a lot of the unexpected. And if I'm honest, throughout all of that unexpected, I found myself coming to God a lot, asking him why. You know, why is this the circumstance? I don't understand. How could this be happening? If you're a good God, are you going to show up? And all of these questions, just showing up at his feet so broken and so confused. And in the middle of all of those questions, I found myself being encouraged to sit down and write and talk to God in ways like I never have before. You know, writing became such a comfort for me in that time and working out those questions. And in the middle of all the questions, I'll be the first to tell you, I am so far from having any of it remotely all figured out. But in the middle of all of it, I do know that our God is a good God and that he's faithful to his promises and that he sees us through in every facet of our lives, even when we don't understand. I think so much of writing and having those conversations with God, even if it's not writing, if for you it's your time in your car or that 5 minutes when you're having your first cup of coffee or right before you go to bed, whenever it is, I think it's so important to be present with God and explore the things that he's putting on your heart, and good or bad, God hears and listens and he's with us. And all this to say, I'll drop you exactly in on the moment. Come with me to April of 2020. I was sitting on the floor of my bedroom looking at a keyboard I've had since probably the sixth grade. I had a title saved in my phone forever and ever and ever. Not really. It was about 4 years, I think, at the time. I had the title Godsend sitting in the notes section of my iPhone, where I keep lots of my song ideas and titles and concepts, all that good stuff. But I'd saved it because it felt special, and I wanted to wait and write it when I knew what I wanted to say. So 2020, month is April, I FaceTimed some friends that I love and write music with, and we decided to write a song about how God is faithful even when we don't understand. And it has since become the title of my record, Godsend, that I just put out last month, which is so crazy. But this became the glue, the foundation that started tying all of these stories together. And I'm really excited to play this one for you. It's so special. It's my dad's favorite, for what it's worth. But this is Godsend. I hope it meets you where you are. My plans.
looking back now. Oh, every closed door, every single sharp thorn, every answer that didn't make sense. What if maybe they were just teaching me to depend on your strength in the dark days? All my tears got me crying out to you again. What if maybe every broken place I've been was a godsend, a godsend, a godsend, yeah. I remember being convinced that never been a winter so cold. Turns out spring was around the corner, and you were turning it into gold. And when I couldn't feel you and it was hard to breathe, I realized I need you. Now I see the beauty in every closed door, every single sharp thorn, every answer that didn't make sense. What if maybe they were just teaching me to depend on your strength in the dark days? All my tears got me crying out to you again. What if maybe every broken place I've been was a godsend, a godsend, it was a godsend. Single sharp thorn, every answer that didn't make sense. What if maybe they were just teaching me to depend on your strength in the dark days? These tears got me crying out to you again. What if maybe every broken place I've been was a godsend, a godsend, it was a godsend.
Here in the room, but I feel that you guys are close. I feel that you're watching. How are you guys feeling? You feeling good? Having fun yet? Is it a party? I hope you said yes to all those things because I'm right there with you. This is a blast. I hope you guys are having a good summer. I feel like the weather's been pretty good. You know, we're on a live stream talking about weather, so that probably means it's time for more music. Isn't that right? Anyway, you guys, just if you don't know, born and raised in the beautiful Nashville, Tennessee, and Nashville is full of incredible songwriters and artists and music and worship and all these amazing things. If you haven't had the opportunity to visit Nashville, I would definitely recommend it. It is a very, very special place, and it's been amazing to see how God has been moving in Nashville through the churches and the people and the community. And it honestly has been such an inspiring time to be here and feel God's goodness and his presence through what he's doing. And this next song was one of those special times where you could just feel a shift in the room as I walked in. As I walked into a session, I just felt the presence of God. I was writing with my friend Jeff Pardo and my other friend Ellie Holcomb. If you guys have heard of her, make some noise from your couch. Ouch. Ellie's amazing. She's an incredible artist and writer and just such a beacon of light and hope and encouragement and goodness and all of those wonderful things. And, you know, writing this song, we all wanted to explore the idea of loneliness and how hard that can be to truly feel lost in the middle of a feeling isolated and by yourself. And I know that is such a real feeling, especially coming out of a year like last year. Loneliness can be really scary, and it's so easy to be convinced that truly we are walking through the challenges alone. And so this next song we wrote very quickly, and we wrote it as a prayer, as a simple reminder that God, you are for me, you are not against me, and I don't walk alone because you're in every single step of the way. It's an easy thing to forget, but it's a simple truth that was true yesterday, every day before that, today, and all of our days in the future. You may be watching this with a group of people you love. You may be by yourself. Wherever you're at, I hope that you are reminded in the deepest part of your soul that God is a good God who is with us on our hardest days and best days, at our most insecure times, because, oh my goodness, we all have those times of insecurity and feeling lost and feeling like our tears are wasted, but God never wastes a tear. He bottles them up and he keeps them, and I think that's a really beautiful idea. So let this song be with you and comfort you. We're singing it together. This is I'm Not Alone.
So unsure anyone could ever love me just the way I am. Turned away, so afraid shame will come and tell me I'm rejected once again. I thought my worth was lost, but it wasn't lost on you. Your arms will hold me up and give me strength to stand. I thought my worth was lost, but it wasn't lost on you. Help me believe what is true. You are for me. Defend me, restore me, and I am not alone. No,
So loved. I think that's such a beautiful thing about a platform and a connector like radio and like what K-Love is doing. And every minute of your day, you can find encouragement and hope and light through the songs that you're hearing. I think it's really a beautiful thing. All of the songs that you're hearing on the radio are written by imperfect people. And they're made for imperfect people who have a very perfect God. So I hope you hear that and you know that and you're reminded of that because it's important and it's true. And that's all the summer motivation you need. I believe it. Having so much fun here. K-Love Summer Concert Series for those who are maybe just joining. Whatever, come on in. We have one more song for you guys before we let you go. Maybe you're going to the pool. Maybe you're having dinner. Maybe you're just waking up. Who knows? But we have one more song for you. And this is a special one because this is my single right now. I'm sorry. My contact is going crazy. Let's see if it'll fix. This is live entertainment, you guys. Hold for technical difficulties. It's all good now. I really hope that makes the cut because that is real life, guys, and you deserve to see all of it. And the contact wearers out there, they know the struggle. And the whole church said amen. Anyway, back to the music. So this next song is a really special one. It's single. You guys might be hearing it on the radio. And walking in to write this song was such a special experience. I think that I had this particular sense of weight and gravity on my shoulders, kind of carrying the weight of the world around just from picking up my phone and scrolling or hearing the TV or even people in my life. I was so inundated with voices and constant content that I was forgetting to listen and make room for the voice of hope, for the voice of God, for the voice of truth in the midst of all of the chaos. And I don't know if you guys have figured this out yet, but God has definitely shown me that without making room for his peace, it is a very unstable place out here. So God has shown me the goodness of what listening for his voice and welcoming him into every moment of your life, the goodness that really brings. So in all the dark days, and all of the hard days, there's a reason to keep your eyes lifted, to keep singing, and to keep hoping, because God is still good. He has still got us all in his hands. For that, I am so grateful. I know you guys are too. But if you guys need to move and get on your feet, this is your chance. We're going to play a song, and it's called Keep On Hoping.
The weight of the world is getting heavier now. Feels like it's far too much to carry around. And each and every little time that you fall starts looking like the end of it all. Somewhere hidden in the noise there's a truth. Someone to believe and hang on to. And each and every little word that you hear, I pray that one thing would be so clear. With all those voices in your head, just don't ever forget that God's still good and he's still got it all in control. Oh, come on and keep on hoping when the days get dark. Keep on singing, don't you ever lose heart. Lift your eyes, the one who gave you life will give you strength to tomorrow's a moment away. What if the morning's just about to break and all the innocence you thought that you lost was there inside of you all along? Come on and keep on hoping when the days get dark. Keep on singing, don't you ever lose heart. Lift your eyes, the one who gave you life will give you strength to keep on.
Y'all believe that? Come on.
There's hope for a world that can change. There's hope for love over hate. 'Cause God's still good and he's still got it all in control. Every breath you breathe, lift your eyes, you're gonna be alright. Just keep going and keep on hoping.
You guys, we have had so much fun with y'all. Give it up for this amazing band back here. Woo, woo, woo. It's such an honor to be part of the K-Love Summer Concert Series. I hope that your summer continues to be blessed and full of hope and light and goodness and new experiences. I just want to encourage all of you guys. You are so loved. You are so seen by the creator of all the universe. And what is better than that? I hope that you feel that and you know that. Whatever walk of life you're in today, you are loved. And anytime you forget that, you need to turn on K-Love, because I promise, they will remind you. I can't wait to see you guys hopefully in person soon. Come on out. I'm going on tour with Torin Wells this fall. We all love Torin. It's going to be so fun. We can't wait to see you there. Come dance and sing and worship with us in real life. But we are sending you all the love. And the band's going to play us out, because that's just what they do. Bye, guys.